Wincaps has a detailed set of timecode settings, which allows it to automatically manage the timecodes to match the requirements for a broadcaster. These rules can be found in the toolbox, under File Info, in the File Properties section, where they can be enabled and modified. Only the rules which are checked will be applied to this file. The subtitle display rate is the speed that the viewer needs to read the subtitles based on the number of words or characters in the subtitle and how long it is on screen. Setting the maximum subtitle display rate will set a limit on this. The higher the maximum subtitle display rate, the shorter that a subtitle can be on screen per character or word, and vice versa. The default subtitle display rate determines the default duration that Wincaps will set for each subtitle according to the number of words or characters it contains. Changing this value will automatically modify the maximum subtitle display rate too. There is no minimum subtitle display rate. Further information on the timing rules can be found in the Help, under Timecodes, Timing Rules. The timing rules can be modified at any time, but this can cause subtitles created earlier to violate the new rules. As subtitles are created, Wincaps uses these rules to make sure that timecodes are set according to the customer's requirements. However, there may still be occasions where timecodes are set in violation of these rules. The user can use timing checks, located in the Checks pane of the toolbox, to highlight these occurrences and decide whether to modify the subtitles or make an exception. As you can see, some of the checks in this example are greyed out. These are the rules that the user has not enabled and will therefore not need to be checked. The Check Only option will simply highlight the subtitles that flag as breaking a rule. The user can use the navigation buttons in the Checks pane to move between flagged subtitles. Using the Check and Review button, we'll take the user through each incident with a problem description and the option to skip with Next or remove the flag with Ignore. The aligner also uses the timing rules to help set the timecodes with the audio. When using the aligner, it is always sensible to run a timing check to confirm that the timing rules have been followed.